Our speaker this morning is a friend of this house, and I got to know him through another friend of mine called Bishop Mark Kariuki. And Bishop Mark Kariuki just told me, I have a friend from South Africa. Would you invite him for a day or two and in church? And he told me, you will love him. And sure enough, we just loved each other. Kutoka hiyo siku. He came and taught us wonderful truths. And some of you have been living those truths. Na maisha yako zilibadilika. Na hata leo naamini kuna watu wanaweza badilika. Urafiki wetu umekomaa. Ananiweza nipigia akiwa South Africa, haangalii gharama. Naweza mpigia kutoka hapa, sitazami gharama. Na wakati niko na haja na shida, wakati mwingine nampigia tu ili niweze kupata neno la hekima ama kwa msaada. Kwa hivyo tumekuwa marafiki. Na mtu ujua mtu ni rafiki. Akiwa mnatembeleana. Kwa hivyo, siku nitawambia ninaenda South Africa. Si hata nyinyi mtanibariki niende nikamuone. Amen. I know some of our people who have visited them in South Africa. Let's all arise and welcome Apostle Simon Kariuki to bring the word of God to us this morning. Let's appreciate him. He has a word for you. He has a word for me.
Unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili we Yesu, unastahili kuabudiwa, una Bwana wa mabwana,
unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili ewe Yesu, unastahili
Yeah. everlasting Father, the God of Israel, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Prince of Peace, the Rock of Ages, the Ancient of Days. Blessed be your holy name. Indeed, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name shall be praised. Baba, tunasema ni asante kwa nafasi hii, badilisha maisha yetu na utubariki, na ni katika jina la Yesu tumeomba, na wacha mtu mmoja aseme, amen. Greet your neighbor, give them a high five as you clap, tell them welcome to the house of your daddy, show them all your teeth, meno yote uwaonyeshe, hata ile iko nyuma mna poketi. Hallelujah. I would want to salute the father of the house, Bishop Jimmy Kemani, and Mama, Pastor Alice Kemani, for the love and the hospitality that I have received over the many years. Indeed, it has been quite a number of years now, and I always enjoy to come here, and I pray that the good Lord will keep you strong, that you shall live long, that you shall move from glory to glory, from one level of impact to another, and that you shall continue to be relevant, even not only to this ministry, but to the nation of Kenya in Jesus' name. As a Kenyan who is a missionary in the southern part of Africa for the past 17 years, I am proud of the excellence that I see in the house. I only wish that that excellence can flow to the roads around here. This place is different from the neighborhood. My nephew, Stephen, who is named after my father, was shocked. He thought I was taking him to the Bundus when we started to enter. You can stand so that you wave. That's, I came with my nephew, the son of my brother, and Jeremiah as well from Meru, 600 kilometers. They decided to come. That excellence will flow to this neighborhood in Jesus' name. I declare that this neighborhood will change in Jesus' name. That you are the agent of change in Jesus' precious and wonderful name. I bring you greetings from my wife, not my knife, say my his wife. You know, some women are wives and some are knives. But I bring you greetings from my wife, who you have seen before. Interesting story, I was married to a Kenyan March 5th. March 6th, I was married to an Australian, same woman. She got her citizenship on March 6th as an Australian. Her father used to be Australian. So I don't know how to behave being married to an Australian. I know how to behave married to a Kenyan. Anyway, some are not getting the joke. Mtaanza kuambia Bishop alioa mke mwingine, lakini hapana. She sends her love. And my children, Kimberly, Christopher, and Katrinika, and my parents, they bring greetings to you. Mepokea salam. I want to bring forth the word of the Lord this morning. And it shall come forth from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1. And I'm hoping to read more verses than I did this early morning. I will read from verse 8 to verse 17 of 1 Samuel chapter 1, from verse 8 to verse 18. And I will use your beautiful screens and ignore my Bible, because kama mna vitu mzuri tuna enjoy. So we can read. Then Elkanah. Ati nini ni kunaendelea sasa? Simsome tu. Say to her. Why do you weep? Why do you not eat? And why is your heart grieved? Am I not better to you than 10 sons? Let's go to the next verse. Hannah arose after they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh. Now Eli, the priest, was sitting on the seat by the doorpost of the tabernacle of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul, prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Then she made a vow, said, O Lord of hosts, if indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I'll give to him, Lord, all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. And it happened, as she continued praying, that Eli watched her mouth. Now Hannah spoke in her heart, only her lips moved. Therefore Eli thought she was drunk. Eli said to her, how long will you be drunk? Put your wine away from you. I am a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor intoxicating drink, but I've poured out my soul before the Lord. Your maidservant, a wicked woman, for out of the abundance of my complaint and grief I've spoken till now. The last verse answered, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant your petition which you have asked. Keep that verse there, because we can take one of the topics of this morning's message from this verse, and it is, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant your petition. That is one of the titles of the message this morning. And you can help me tell your neighbor, go in peace. Not now, later you will go in peace. Go in peace, and the God of Israel grant. I'll be speaking about go in peace and the God of Israel grant your petition. Another title of the message this morning is intercession for intervention. Intercession for intervention. And I'm sure as I go along, you will be able to get many titles out of this message. And I'm believing God that I am a messenger of intervention in your life this morning. I'm believing that God has sent me so that a situation that has caused you pain, a situation that has caused you problems, a situation that has caused you many, many sleepless nights, that God is going to bring a solution in Jesus' name. You have come to a house of peace. You have come to a house of solution. And I declare in Jesus' mighty name that you shall not live the same way you came in Jesus' name. I might not know what is your name, but I believe that the God who sees, the God who is omnipotent, the God who is omniscient, that he will intervene in your situation in Jesus' mighty name. I was fascinated by this story of Hannah. Because she had a personal problem. And the problem was barrenness. She was married in a home where there were two wives. The other one, her name was Penina. And she was the loved one. And I just want to mention that the power of love at this point, and invite you to South Africa for the couples. The couples, that bus that you are buying can make it to South Africa. I've driven a smaller bus from South Africa to here. So I'm inviting, instead of you just going Zimmerman, Zimmer Harper, take a trip and come to South Africa. That bus should cross borders, for goodness sake. And you are welcome to Pretoria. I will increase the rooms there. We have a very nice honeymoon suite, but I don't think I can host all of you, but enough to host maybe 50 couples, but we will build more. We will build more. We have enough land to build. Wow. However, so karibuni, and the atmosphere is very romantic. So you can inform the couples wherever they are that they are welcome to Pretoria, South Africa. And I'm just thinking the issue of the power of love for a moment, that this man marries two women, but there is one he loves, and her name is Hannah. But she has a challenge of giving birth. The one he doesn't like or love as much, she's making babies every year, like stairs. Leo anatoa hapa, next year anatoa mwingine. Unajua kuna wale, kila mwaka, wazee hawapati kupumzika, katoto, katoto. I was praying for a family in Nakuru. I was preaching in Nakuru last week. I went to this home where they gave me mbuzi. They said to me, there are 14 children. 14. Nikasema hiyo ni baraka kubwa. So Penina is producing children, many of them, and I pray that God gives you children. They are a blessing in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Naona hapa kuna sadaka hii ni narudi hapa. So Penina is producing children, but they are not being born out of love. They are being born just for the sake, you know. And I have noted in the scriptures that when children are just born, not out of love, there is a difference when a child is born out of love, and there is a difference when a child is not born out of love. And I will tell you this story clearly, because I've taken note of Jacob marrying two women and the children who ended up winning, Joseph and Benjamin. They were of the woman who was loved, and the rest were not. And this story I'm reading is the same. The child that was born out of love had impact. So I want to release a love bug in this church. I want to declare that you shall be loved. Say you shall be loved. I've come to deal with the barrenness of love. Those who are in a desert of love, your season to be loved has come. Your season to be loved has come. Barrenness is not only physical, it can be spiritual, it can be financial. And we have come to wage spiritual warfare this morning against every form of barrenness, even the barrenness in our nation. We have come as prophets to declare that where there was barrenness, there shall be fruitfulness in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm talking about Hannah's barrenness. I thought it was just a personal problem, but when I investigated further, I saw that her barrenness was representing the barrenness, spiritual barrenness of the whole nation. You know, sometimes you can be going through a challenge and you think it is just your challenge, but God wants you to overcome that challenge so that you become a picture of solution for the whole nation. I want to declare upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus that when God ministers to you this morning, that you shall be a solution in your family, you shall be a solution in your community, that Kenya will receive answers because you came this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So Hannah's issue of barrenness was not just a personal problem. It was a picture of the situation in Israel. The voice of God was rare. If you read the scriptures in Samuel, you realize that God was distant. He was far. He was not communicating as he should because there was sin. Israel had deviated from the purposes and the plans of God, and so there was spiritual barrenness. When there is spiritual barrenness, you don't hear the voice of God well. The word of God becomes rare. There is no revival. People do what they want. But when there is no barrenness, there is revival. So what happens is Hannah initially has conflict with Penina. Penina
represents provocation and frustration. And I've come to deal with frustrations. Yeah. How many people have ever been frustrated? There are many ways you can be frustrated. People can frustrate you. And there are people who are experts in frustrating others. And those people are not in this church. They are only somewhere else, in another deliverance maybe, but not in the one in Zimmerman. There are people, if they decide to frustrate you, they can frustrate you. There are women, if they decide to frustrate their husbands, the husband will be fully frustrated. You know, some husbands, I look at them and I see they are coming from a house of frustration. And I will not explain how they frustrate. It is you who is the strategist of frustration. Me, I am a strategist of solution in Jesus' name. Penina knew how to frustrate Hannah. And she frustrated and provoked her to the extent that she was crying continually. Because every time she's pregnant, she would appear pregnant. I've got a baby, you are barren. I've got a car, you are walking. Do you know there are people when they get the car, they will never give you a lift. They will make sure they drive very quietly when it is so rainy and muddy, the rain is falling on you and they are driving their car so that you see they have. That was Penina. She knew how to drive her point home. Let me prophesy to you. Those who have been frustrating you, the tables are turning around. After the meeting this morning, you are going to have a good laugh. Because God is about to silence your mockers. He's about to silence all those who are frustrating you. I have come as a messenger from afar to declare that your problems have an expiry date. Your frustrations have an expiry date. They are not meant to be for life. Your day of rejoicing and smiling is coming. But you need to understand some things. Sometimes we are too busy arguing and answering back the people who are frustrating us. And we forget where our solution is. I don't know for how long Hannah had an engagement with Penina, but what I know is that the day she decided to go to the house of the Lord, that is where her solution came from. The house of the Lord. I'm glad that Jeff, the one who was married here, came here a frustrated man. Kwani wamekufanyia nini ukapata kabindi kazuri namna hii? His school of leadership wana kufundisha namna gani? Hebu kuja. Huja mali kuja hapa single. Hey. Possibly broke.
Confused.
Sasa ukimuona navaka designer kashat kapoa. Where was his solution? The house of God is your place of solution. When Hannah took the matter, her issue with Penina, to the house of God, that is where she found her solution. And I just want to share with you the things I shared this morning, and they will be starting with the letter I. All of them, most of them with letter I. Because when she went to the house of God, which was in Shiloh, before I come to the letter I's, let me share with you, she came to Shiloh. I want to speak about Shiloh for a moment, because you are going to have a Shiloh moment this morning. I want to explain Shiloh from a Judah point of view, because Judah is the one who was given the mandate for Shiloh, that out of Judah would come Shiloh. And Shiloh, the word Shiloh speaks peace. The word Shiloh is a center, the place of the scepter. Shiloh is a place of sacrifice. Shiloh is the place of solution. Shiloh is a son. Shiloh is Jesus himself. And Shiloh is Judah. Muko. Kwa nini mimi natoka jasho namna hiyo nyingi? This is, I'm also Jimmy in a bit. So the Bible says that Hannah went to Shiloh, where there was a priest called Eli. And when she went there, to present her petition before God, to pray. The first I is intercession. And I'm talking about intercession that can cost. You need to pray. When you have a problem, the first I is prayer, intercession. I'm calling it intercession. Two important components of your prayer, of your intercession. Component number one is that for your intercession to be effective, to be able to break the back of barrenness, to be able to reverse the challenge you are going through, your intercession must have, number one, intensity. Right. Number two, intentionality. So I am talking about intercession that can cause a difference, okay? I'm talking about prayer, in case the word intercession becomes a problem. And I'm bringing in two important factors that can help you in this area of your prayer life. Why are some prayers never answered? And why are some prayers quickly answered? My prayer is that your prayer will be quickly answered. Usiombe inagonga sili na inarudi. Two things. Intensity and intentionality. Intensity and intentionality. When Hannah prayed, she prayed with a lot of intensity until she looked drunk. Wewe umewahi kuomba mpaka watu wakashindwa huyu? Kwani ni nini kinaendelea? Kuna watu wakiabudu huwa wanaenda full swing. Hata wewe unasema huyu ako serious mahali, lakini kuna wale wanaabudu kimchezo. Kuna wale wakiomba wanaomba na roho moja. Leo ni siku yako ya kuomba na roho moja. Amen. Leo ni siku yako ya kuomba na roho moja. You need to pray with a lot of intensity. And you might tell me God looks at the heart, but he also looks at the way we do our things. I gave an example of how I used to have a prayer partner, a Nigerian, in our early days in Botswana. I also lived in Botswana for 4 years. He was a pastor in a different church. I was pastoring another one. And we had agreed that every week we pray. But this Nigerian friend who is a pastor, when he prays, he would be walking like this, pulling things from on top. By the time he's done whatever he's praying for, mimi pale niko pale the Kenyan style ya kumba baba wewe ni mzuri. Nikiangalia ile kona ingine, ninaambia Mungu kule naona kutajibiwa haraka. Ule jamaa ametoka mishipa. Ndio hiyo jasho. Okay, look, I know that God looks at the heart. But I would admire. I would say, I think this man is too intense. Well, look, there is a place for intensity. There's a place for what? Put intensity whenever it is needed. Number two, intentionality. When Hannah prayed, she said, give me a child and I will give this child back to you. I will lend this child back to you. A lot of prayers we make are selfish prayers. They don't benefit God. They don't benefit the kingdom. They don't even benefit even sometimes your family. Nipatie Range Rover. ndio nikiendesha hapa Zima watu wajua hata mimi niko. Hiyo Range Rover itawahi kubeba mtu wa kanisa mhubiri? How is that Range Rover benefit in God? Hey, oh, nimeambiwa ni wipe. Kuna mtu anaangalia hiyo jasho anaona ni nyingi. Do you want your prayers quickly answered? Give me a husband. So that neighbor who sees that, like, I don't have one. Is that the way to pray? I think the key thing is that if you want your prayers answered, be intentional. Attach a vow. Huh? Give me a good paying job. And this church will never struggle in particular areas financially. I'll not only be giving 10%, I'll be giving 20, 40, or 50%. A person who prays that kind of prayer is simply making their prayers go on the fast track. Their prayers will move quicker. But a person who just prays without intentionality, they are going to struggle. Let me declare this to you, that today you will make a vow. You will say, Lord, I have a challenge. Do sort this out for me, and this is what I will do for you. Amen. How many people want an answer? Make a vow and write it down. Don't be foolish. Because the Bible also warns us about making vows that we are not willing to fulfill. Right. There are people who have made many vows. And part of the reason why they are going through struggles is because they forgot the vows they made. They broke those vows. And the pastor can pray for you so much, and prayers are not coming because God is saying, if only this person could fulfill their vow, I will answer them. There are prayers that are never answered because of promises we made to God that we have forgotten to fulfill. I've come as a debt collector. I've come as a debt collector. I've come as a debt collector. Please make sure if there is something you promised God, fulfill it. Don't forget. So Hannah's prayer was not only, intercession was not only intense, it was intentional. Huh? Give me so that I give back. Give me so that I give back. You give me this blessing, I need it so much. She needed Samuel so much. And this kind of prayer must include sacrifice. Look, if God gave you an Isaac, then demanded the Isaac back, gave you a car, and said, that car is not yours, take it to the house of God, would you do it? Kwani mkinyamaza hivi ni poa ama disease nini? Unajua watu kama iko kitu umekuwa unaombea kwa muda mrefu ije, alafu Bwana aitishe, hapo ndio test iko. The test is when you are able to give sacrificially that which you yourself you need. When it comes to giving, I don't expect amens, but amen, hallelujah. Let me shout my own amen and hallelujah. So your prayers, your intercession must be intentional. It must also be intense. Whenever you are intense, it will lead to interrogation. Interrogation. Anybody who is intense in prayer, in their work, in their relationship, they attract interrogation. Hannah was interrogated by the priest because he did not understand how she's praying. Unajua, there are no more prayers which will not be interrogated by anybody. Wewe piga tu magoti hapa na uombe quietly. Baba, wewe ni mwema, hallelujah. Lakini nikiona baba usiatararua kiti, hallelujah. Caretaker John, anaitwa John Mwaura, John Boru atakuja bila interrogation. Hebu kuja, ni nini kwani, ni nini kunaendelea? wamewahi kufanya vitu. You know, before I married my wife, I think I fell in love with her intensity. I used to teach them Bible study. Sasa tukianza kuabudu, yeye anaanza kuabudu. Machozi ndio. Anaenda. Anazama. Hata mimi kama mchungaji naanza kuangalia huyu vile anaomba. Until nikampropose na nikammarry. Huyo mama wa kwangu alikuwa intense. Kwanza akiabudu akiitwa. Ukienda haleluya haleluya. Kuna nyimbo tukiziimba hizo nyimbo. Machozi itatoka nyingi. Asa hawa hata ana makeup. Me, I love intense people. So, intensity can lead to interrogation. And some of you don't want to be interrogated. Temperature inapanda. Unaanza kuwaka ati kwa sababu umeulizwa swali. Ni nani au every your spiritual father has the right to ask you why you are doing some things the way you are doing. But the problem with the believers of today, if you ask them or interrogate them, they want to move from that church. Se kwani wanafikiria hii ndio kanisa tu, wanaenda ingine. Submit yourself to any form of interrogation of your leader, because your leader means well. When Eli asked Hannah, why are you behaving like a drunk woman? She explained. She gave information. Another I is information. Provide the necessary information that will explain your situation. Whenever you come to the house of God, have the right information. Information is important. Supply. Say, this is what is my problem. The issue is not I'm not drunk. The issue is that I'm going through a challenge of barrenness. Eh? Kuna watu nikiombea, baadaye ninasema hawa watu wamepoteza muda yangu. Mtu anakuja ofisi, pastor niombe. Naanza kumuombea, sasa nafikiria ni kichwa hapa. In Jesus name, kichwa toka. Baadaye kutoka, baadaye nina discover ni tumbo. Muna huku niambia ni tumbo. Why don't you just give me the right information so that we deal with the problem? Be specific in your request. Kama ni mtoto unataka, kama ni ndoa unataka, kama ni pesa unataka, wacha kupiga kona kona. Nibariki tu. Unataka kubarikiwa namna gani? So, information. Interrogation led to information and interaction. There is power when you interact with somebody who is your divine helper or solution carrier. There are people you should be careful when you interact with them, because the interaction can lead to something else. When you interact with a spiritual leader, be sensitive enough to understand who you're interacting with, or your father, physical or spiritual, because one word from them can change your life. You are here to receive something. The interaction and the information that Hannah gave led to what I call impartation. And that is the key, right? Impartation. Hiyo kwanza unaweka capital. Impartation. If you interact with a spiritual leader, like Hannah interacted with Eli, then it does not lead to impartation. There is a problem. Because this is what Eli said to Hannah, which changed her life. See that? Hata kama nataka kuwa smart, honestly. Simunisamehe kidogo. Hii mambo ya kuwa smart kweli ni important at this point. Simumeona nimewaheshimu. Nikitoa mtafikiria sijawaheshimu. Niliwaheshimu zamani. Naweza toa tai, lakini msitatoa zaidi ya hapo. I'm just playing around with you people. I'm saying, the whole story of interrogation, information, interaction led to what is most important. And this is where I want to stick for a bit. It led to impartation. And that impartation is this story of 1 Samuel 1:17. Go in peace. Go in peace. Go in peace. Amen. And the God of Israel grant your petition. Can you imagine after she has explained her barrenness? I'm barren. I thought Eli should address and say, I bind the spirit of barrenness in Jesus' name. I'm well kelem kono. I bind your spirit. Eli atatoki kwa kiti. Imagine, kuna watu kama wewe ni siku za Eli unezaona ni madharau. Eli, umemwambia shida kubwa na una expect. Atasimama, apige ndimi 30 minutes. Baada ya kupiga ndimi, awekele mkono kichwa. You know the methodology of how you receive can make you not receive. This is, you have to be careful. Because Eli does not even mention her barrenness. Imagine, she said she's barren. This is what Eli says. Go in peace. And the God of Israel, grant your petition. Kama ni wengine wenyu, ungemwambia Eli, how could mention barrenness? Ulisahau kuniambia kusema ile deni nilikuambia ninayo haukuimention. Ile ugonjwa haukuisema. Ile shida ninayo na mume wangu haukuisema. Kwa nini wewe unaniambia go in peace? Maybe my problem has nothing to do with peace. What has barrenness to do with peace? And I'm here to tell you that some of the times when God says go in peace, you might say, how is that going to solve my problem? But I'm here to submit to you the two principles that Eli submitted to Hannah. They carried too many things. Go in peace. Peace, according to scripture, is shalom. Shalom is not just lack of harmony or rest. Shalom has prosperity in it. Shalom has progress in it. Shalom has productivity in it. When God said go in peace, when Jesus was going through a storm, there was a storm the disciples had. He never said stop storm. He said peace, be still. All right. When you talk about going peace, peace carries what you need. So let me say, go in peace. In that peace, you will find progress. In that peace, you will find productivity. In that peace, you will find promotion. In that peace, your barrenness will be turned into fruitfulness.
Amen.
Mpo. Kama mpo hebu inyweni mikono juu nione. Kuna wengine wanakujanga kulala kanisa. Na najua hapa kuna Elisha room ya kulala, lakini si hapa. So, go in peace. Number one thing you need to understand is how to receive impartation. Impartation is through the spoken word. How do you receive your solution? It is not always that people must lay hands on your head. Some of you are missing impartation because your expectation is not what you are getting from the servant of God. Do you know you can receive impartation through the spoken word?
Right.
Do you know you can receive impartation through observation? How did Elisha receive the double portion of the anointing? He was told, if you see me living, even by seeing with the eyes of the spirit, you can receive impartation. So impartation can be received in different ways. Being in an environment that is charged with anointing is enough for you to receive impartation. You can receive impartation even when you are sleeping in the night. How did Solomon receive wisdom? Nobody laid hands on him. It was a dream he had. He slept foolish, he woke up wise. May somebody receive that in Jesus' name. Leo usiku lale na ulikuwa na ujinga nyingi ya kutosha. Unajua kuna watu wana ujinga tu. Si hapani, naambia juu ya wengine. Kuna watu hata ukimuexplainia hii message. Eh? Hatakuwa stuck na trivial things. Eh? Watu wana ujinga nyingi kukana, unachoka. Na mimi sitakangi watu wana ujinga. Natakanga mtu anashika mambo haraka, tunaenda. Kuna mtu namuexplainia kitu mara kumi. Ithe wari eko. Nikukuthi wega weko. Agashoka doro ini. Ithe wari agashoka doro ini. Ugehikyo ni mudu mukigu. Na hiyo nimeongea Kikuyu. Wacha sasa nikuje Kiswahili. Don't worry, I'll translate. For all that don't speak Kikuyu. And after all, I don't speak much of it because I don't live here. So give me the liberty to practice for a minute or two. Do you know Abigail was married to a foolish man? There is no danger. You know some women, they are just looking for cash, car, and cell phone. Even if the man is full of ujinga. Cash, car, and cell phone. Mtu tu mjinga, hata unaona ni mjinga na unamuoa kwa sababu ana cash card na cell phone. I'm telling you, your home can sink. I don't say it, the scripture says it. And you know, if it was not for Abigail's wisdom, the whole house would have been swept like that. And in fact, even David said to her after she cooled him down, she said, go in peace. Go in peace. She said it. So it's important for you. Hey, time up. Ninamaliza, namaliza. Yo kitu amwezi increase kidogo. Yo, kwa ninaandikanga, ni mimi nanionea hii kitu. When I'm up here, mwoni nikaandika time up. Na leo tena inarudi wakati na wahubiria. Inanionea sana. I'm saying impartation, impartation. May you receive impartation this morning in Jesus' name. I raise my hand to declare by virtue that I've been to many countries of the world, hautakuwa unazunguka tu zima, utasafiri. Impartation can come by, because you cannot impart what you don't have. Huh? Impartation. Receive it in Jesus' name. Because God has intervened in my life when I needed it, may God intervene in your life as well. Because my mother is back to Kenya, who in South Africa for almost a month, the doctor said she's not coming out. Cancer imeingia. Tunampeleka emergency, anafungua kamacho hivi. You can't go with the plane. Tumerudi tukiimba hallelujah kwa ndege ndio imenilete. Mama alikuwa anafungua macho hivi. Anasema dira kwera goko. I'm not dying in a foreign land and my time to die is not now. That the report of the doctors are saying finished. Finished. Mimi mwenyewe nikisoma na mimi ni mtu wa faith nashindwa, what do I have the faith report from the scriptures and the facts from the doctors. They were really confusing me. Because this one now, the fact report from the doctor, he kusoma si kitu kizuri. Saa zingine gumbaro si ni mzuri. Usijue kusoma sana. Well, nasoma hii naona platelets zero. Blood count iko hivi. Haya. Kwa hivyo daktari akisema anaenda, achezi, there is proof. Nawaambia jamani, tumerudi na mama kwa ndege vizuri, tuko huko juu tunasema haleluya. Na tukasema ile roho ya kifo ilikuwa huko South Africa, haiwezi tawala hapa. Huku ni kwa uhai, si ndio? Huku ataishi katika jina la Yesu. If somebody is sick, may the Lord intervene in your life in Jesus' name. The same God who has come through for us. Yes. As a family when we were going through difficulty. May he come through for you in Jesus' name. Yes. So, I'm finishing. So, impartation is something you need. Through laying of hands. Through spoken word. Centurion said, don't come at home. Just speak. What do you need this morning? Receive the word from the heavens in Jesus' name. Lastly, is impact. Na nimemaliza. Impartation is not the end of the story. If you receive impartation that does not lead to impact, problems. Hannah, okay, by the way, I forgot another eye in the morning. And that was so important. Impartation should lead to intimacy. This one I forgot in the morning. Go in peace. So, when there was go in peace, which was impartation, Hannah and the husband needed to go and become intimate. And because there is no impact without intimacy, impartation should lead you to a closer relationship with God. Impartation should lead you to a close place of relationship. Intimacy. Intimacy. And some of you don't, for men, intimacy is one thing, for women is another. But I'm talking about the women kind of intimacy. Time and sharing. Intimacy, impartation should lead to intimacy, and then it should finalize with impact. My conclusion is this. Hannah did not give birth to just Samuel. She gave back to national impact. She gave birth to what? What are you giving birth to? When you have received impartation, it can be for international impact, national impact, organizational impact, home impact. I don't know what you are receiving, but I declare that the impartation will lead to intimacy and it will lead to impact. Mmeshika. Bas. Tukitoka, nitawekelea hiyo kichwa mkono hapo. Baadaye tukimaliza ibada, si ndio? Kama hujaokoka, this story is just a story. Eh? You need to come and know the Prince of Peace as Lord and Savior. Okay? So those who are not born again, I call you forth to begin the life of impact in Jesus' name. All right. Bishop atakuja na yeye ndio atafanya hiyo ombi. Ile yangu mimi imebaki ni kuwekelea mikono mkitoka. Unaleta kichwa, pokea. Kwa sababu wengine usipowekelea mkono haelewi. Lakini wengine wamepokea already. Wangapi wamepokea already? Wewe, wengine wenu mnatabidi tu muangalie tumbo hii kubwa hivi unapokea. Hata mimi nitanona siku moja kwa sababu wewe niangalie tu. Ukiniangalia hivi unaangalia, hata mimi siku moja nitahubiri kama huyu. Sawa? Simbarikiwe. Amen. Barikiweni sana.